Okay, let's see. Try to avoid to collide on the other boat. Tacking is a very important maneuver in sailing because it allows the sailboat to change direction and then move upwind. Since you cannot sail straight into the wind, you have to turn the direction of the sail from one side to the other, and this allows you to propel forward. The reason we were interested in this maneuver was because it is a very critical move in sailing, and getting it right means that you can keep your speed and control for the boat. This study can enable us to understand the basic physics of the maneuver and also study in detail what makes a tacking maneuver successful or not. You cannot sail straight into the wind, so what you have to do is take this part of the sail, which is called the boom, and then you have to change the angle from, let's say, A, like let's say this is 10 degrees, to minus 10 degrees into the wind. So this is the initial shape of our sail. Now I will perform a tacking maneuver, and if it's successful, it means that this will flip to the mirror image of the initial shape. So if this is the wind and I'm doing this, this will be a successful tack. So for the mainsail, what we are doing is trimming, which means we are controlling how much tension we are providing to the cord that controls the boom. The rudder, which is the part attached at the back of the boat that goes into the water, is controlling the steering of the boat. So if we want to change direction, we have to use the interplay between the two. In our study, we provide a detailed characterization for how the sail behaves under different material properties and for a wide range of tacking motions as well. And we found that the stiffness of the sail, so its ability to extend or not, the tension before encountering the wind, and the final angle of attack relative to the wind determine whether a sail flips at all or not. Something surprising in our findings was that slack sails, so ones that are more relaxed, that have less tension, are actually harder to flip. So you can control many things here. You can control the final angle of attack relative to the wind. You can control how fast I do this motion and the acceleration. So you can imagine that I do this at a constant rate. You can imagine that I do it fast at the beginning and then slowly, or that I do it slowly at the beginning and then very quickly. We also thought that if you do the tacking motion quickly at first and then more slowly, would help with the tacking time being smaller. But instead, we found cases in which doing the tack fast at the beginning and then the turn being more slow at the end could actually slow things down. Sailors and engineers can use this kind of information to their advantage, both to improve efficiency and performance. It's harder in practice, actually, than in theory.